then run it back. Run it back, run it back, run it back. Hey, how fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch, like every time I touch down, I gotta stunt. Randy Moss, yeah, my numbers going up. All these trophies, what do I need any more for? Check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard. Check the stats, Jay Critch, I'm the QB. Ran it up and then I went and got a new freeze. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back.
Coach, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Lone Star State and the very mammoth AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction to the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football in Big D as their guys will do battle with Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. This is Corey Clement, the third-year back from Wisconsin. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. Cowboys and Eagles, of course, such a great rivalry. Last year, the Cowboys got the better of the Eagles both times that they met, with Philly coming off their Super Bowl title. But in weeks 10 and 14, it was Dallas beating Philly by a single possession. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Bad news, they didn't get it on second down. The good news is they still only need about 3 or 4 inches here on third.
And the good play callers have looked at both situations. They thought to themselves, okay, this call, I pick up the first down, already ready with that call. If I don't, this is what I'm going to come back with in order to pick it up.
Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. Nothing doing on second and third down after that 9-yard gain on first. Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And a great job on special teams to doubt it, as this will be marked out inside the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. They run with Ezekiel Elliott, last year's NFL rushing leader. And from the 4, they get it to the 8 on a pickup of 4. Tackle made that time by Brandon Graham.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and 6. At the 8.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6.
Watch tight. Tight end's right. Watch tight. Tight end's right. We got 4. We got 4. 36. 36.
Here's Elliott. And they'll get him down up past the 15. It's a first down on a gain of 10. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
Pass on target, Prescott to Cooper. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Watch the ship, watch the ship. Hey, watch the ship, watch the ship. Check, 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 check.
Now Elliott. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple.
Ain't no such thing as a luck.
Looking to throw. Prescott completes it right side to Cooper. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
The last catch took him 2 yards in the wrong direction, so now what can they do on third?
That's got to be
46.
53 is the mic. 53 is the mic.
Let's go, truck.
Let's go, let's go. Have we got mic number?
Go, kill, kill.
46.
Prescott from the gun. He's got his try, but it's called. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
There you go. 49.
Check 53. I'm here all day.
26.
Now back to the ground with Elliott. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4. For Zeke, what a first 3 years he's had in the NFL. Last year, his second rushing title, 1,434 yards. Not as many as 1,631 that he had as a rookie, but still his yards per game average was the best in the National Football League.
Here we go.
From the 44, Prescott. And he hits Jason Witten, the tight end. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 33. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far.
Watch the twist. Watch the twist.
They're going to 53.
Switch, switch, switch. Wide. Get wide. Alert 3.
A first down carry by Elliott. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
A gain of 4. It's now second and 6.
No score after 1 on EA Sports. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession as they are looking at a second down and 6 coming up. On second down, it's Elliott. And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. A second down play results in a loss of 2 yards.
Count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there, because this has been a pretty long drive, and normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let him down a little bit.
They allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff him for a loss.
Hey, kill. Kill.
Mike's 50. Here we go, D. Hey, it's just me and you.
On third down, it's Prescott. He's going to let this go for the... That is caught. It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown. Amari Cooper, his 4th touchdown on the year. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. Extra point by Marr, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Hurry up,
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
A good run got seven on first. Here's second and three. On play action, it's Wentz. He's going to float this one deep right side. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. And Xavier Woods with a pick. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. Well, certainly not how he wanted to start his night. First throw of the game, an INT.
Yeah, it's not easy, but he's got to try and wipe that one away from the memory banks. And let's face it, it's not often a quarterback and a defensive back have a lot in common. But one thing, because they have these individual-type plays, they've got to have short memories, don't they? DB gets beat, wipe it away, quarterback throws a pick, has to do the same thing.
They start on the ground with Elliott. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down. His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Second down, Elliott. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the...
I'm going back to you. Show it up.
We're going to 54. Why?
Slam, slam, slam. Watch the safety creep.
They keep on the ground with Elliott. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory.
You got it.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Tenth carry now for Elliott. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A gain there of 21 yards. Even from up here in the booth, the play-by-play guy could tell that there was some pretty good blocking on the right side of the line.
Well, you have good eyes, and it's almost like a ballet when it's executed that well. Everyone in the right spot, everyone in sync, everyone hitting the perfect notes. A little more percussion and a lot more bass, I would think, than you get your normal ballet. But at the same time, that was well executed.
Two minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Prescott looks to throw on first. Caught left side by Cobb. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Two first-half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. Extra point by Marr, up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded at the two. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. On second down, Clement. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a third and three.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Wentz going to try and throw on third. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A first down and then some. 36 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Wentz leaves with Clement on the draw. And he'll work this back to right around the line of scrimmage and surrender there. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Wentz. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. DeMarcus Lawrence in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year. Throwing his Wentz. He's going to go for it all. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. So we come upon halftime with our score 14-0. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. That's fielded in the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. A little bit of space there for the first down run, as that's going to get him about 5 yards. It was Josh Sweat who got him down on the defensive side.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five at the 35-yard line.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five.
Don't get nervous.
Got a one open man. It's Michael Gallup. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 12 yards there and a first down. With Cole Beasley now in Buffalo, you think that might open up some more targets for Michael Gallup. Last year as a rookie, 33 catches for the Dallas Cowboys.
Switch.
We're going to 54 right here. We're going to 53.
Check.
They'll run on first down. It's Elliott. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
The last run got six, now second and four.
Hey, watch it.
To throw is Prescott. On the left side, Gallup's got it. Pass, and he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Cowboys. Three touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, second half, no matter what, whether it's first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Here's Wentz to throw. And he fends him off. And a big loss here as he's taken down. DeMarcus Lawrence in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades.
Under pressure again, and down he goes again. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it.
I think we've seen this before. Someone's down three scores. That situation there, it's just going to add to their growing frustration, don't you think?
Yeah, a bad number three right now. Three-score game, third quarter, three and out, not what they wanted. And you can tell on the sideline, those faces are getting a little bit longer as this one goes. Now, this is a nice little gift wrap situation as they take over first and goal. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. So a loss of five, and it'll be second down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
Moved back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here.
Hey, watch the ball. Watch the ball. Hatchy. He's coming. Double up. He's coming. Double up.
They'll try again with Elliott. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. When you talk about a battle being won in the trenches, that touchdown right there, a lot of credit to the offensive linemen.
Yeah, when you watch them surge across the front, they really created great space for the runner to get in.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
How many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Play action, now wins. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked up by Leighton Vander Esch. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
He's checking crap.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he'll find some room to get this up to about the 14. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six.
Jim.
Watch that.
On second down, it's... Tony Pollard.
Defensive guys, plays like that really hurt.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
From the 24, Wentz. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. Well, this secondary has done such a good job of frustrating these receivers tonight. Another example right there on the deep ball.
Sometimes when the sun goes down and it's just the bright lights in the stadium, puts a little extra spring in their step, doesn't it? And that's what we're seeing from the defenders. Doesn't matter whether it's man or zone, deep ball, short ball, and that was a deep one there. They are making plays on the football, contesting everything.
And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. Jalen Smith. In there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down. Here's Matt Bosher now. Back now in Arlington. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Here's Matt Bosher now, standing just outside his own goal line. Yards on the return that time, and the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10.
Where
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get
nowhere to go. Here, he lost the football.
And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. A three-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. He gets it over the middle to Cobb. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 22 yards there, a first down. Dak Prescott last year against Philly. Boy, biggest game of his career passing yardage-wise. 455 yards, three touchdowns, in a 29-23 December victory over the Eagles.
Hey, here we go. Joining.
Check 52 to Mike.
Let's go, tight end. Let's go right here now.
26.
Another carry tonight for the workhorse, Elliott. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
Brandon, this is clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
We're going to 54. Why here?
52's the mic. Watch Mike. Watch Mike. Here we go. D, all day. Defense, all day.
Fuzz. No, check that. Check that.
On second and 15 now. Prescott. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Sacked by the outside backer, Telvin Smith.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Let's go, defense.
Here we go, going to 54, going to 54, wide in.
Six.
We're going to 54, wide in.
26.
Third and long for Prescott. This is Cobb with a catch right side. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. They get 13, but it's not nearly enough. And it'll be fourth down. Out now comes the Cowboys punter, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. He was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here is away.
Let's go, baby. Let's go.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Now second and 7 from the 23. They'll run again with Clement. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with the run in the pass. But in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done.
It'll be a gain of 4, but it won't be enough. It leaves them with a fourth down now. They're already slim. Hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. Trying to pick it up with Clement. And an alley to run. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On first and 10, it's Clement. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Wentz defers to Clement. Now we'll get a stoppage here as it appears we've got an Eagle slow to get up. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. The Eagles on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is 3rd and 9. To throw is Wentz. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. It's Christian Covington who notches the sack there.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. Wentz going to go on fourth down. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Sean Lee, the longtime vet, getting in and getting to the QB. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
Throwing here, Prescott. He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because if you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
Throw right side, taken in by Gallup. A gain there of 21 yards.
Go ahead and throw the ball, man. You got the big lead. You got the clock on your side. Obviously, they don't care much about the feelings of the other team, do they?
Well, I was going to say, you better run to the locker room pretty quick after this one.
But right now, maybe they're just looking at it from the fantasy perspective. More points for everyone if they win big.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
Hey, 47!
Let's go.
Throwing again. Prescott on 2nd and 10. His throw incomplete. He was trying to get it to Ezekiel Elliott, and it'll bring up 3rd down.
Okay, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? The leg's still there. This has been a tough game. The Cowboys on 3rd down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10.
Mike's 50.
They'll throw again. Prescott going to throw deep for the end zone. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown. That's how you, Charles. You play to the final whistle, I get that. But there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with this one. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it, on the other side is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
I guarantee you, I know who was really excited. Fantasy owners who had them. Hey, listen, get the points for me. They're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff.
So Dak will bring the Cowboys up to go for the 2-point try. Prescott yet again. And this is going to be caught. So add 2 more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. fielded about a yard deep. Now a hit and a loose football. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy, because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Throwing now is Wentz. And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Eagles coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack.
Solid.
From the gun, it's Wentz. He's going to let it fly. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. And Xavier Woods with a pick. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. Prescott now 14 out of 17, 82%, and it's first and 10. Well, Prescott here to throw. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They are down big. They have not scored a single point. I don't know. Are they so defeated at this point you just want to get in the locker room and get the heck out of here?
That is one way to approach it. Sometimes coaches say, that's it, okay? It hasn't worked all game. There's no sense in doing something now. Let's get out of here. No one gets hurt. But others will look at it and say, we still have an opportunity to do something.
Yeah, there's pride on the line.
Exactly. You have pride on the line.